Well, welcome back to the Steve Robb Show. Today we're going to have some fun, and we're going to have some fun with electricity, AC and DC. The whole purpose of this video is to explain a little bit about electricity and how there's a huge difference between AC and DC when it comes to using a power inverter. Now, the one I got here is the one that I showed a little while ago. It's my 3000 watt power inverter. It's kind of a unique inverter, different than other inverters that I do own and have used. And today we're going to hook it up to that machine right there, my DeWalt 12 inch chop saw, and it's rated at 15 amps. And it's completely wrong. It's completely wrong from the manufacturer, 15 amps. A lot of people look at that and say, oh, it runs on 15 amps. Well, no, it doesn't. So let's get down to some little bit of experiments here. I think I have a little bit of fun, and we'll look at some meters, and we'll see how you have to actually test every piece of equipment you want to put into service when you're using an inverter. And most people don't think about these things, and a lot of people just would like to know a little bit more information about inverters, how they actually work, how you use them, and you're going to find out a little more about the ratings on power tools. So let's get to that right now. Well, here we go right here with my DeWalt chop saw, rated at 15 amps. And this is a terrific saw. I love this thing, but no, it's not 15 amps. So I'm going to show you the kind of testing we're going to do here. Okay, so here we are here. I got my meters all lined up. This one here is going to measure the amperage. I got my amp clamp on here. You don't have to spend a lot of money on an amp clamp, guys. I just got that one here because it attaches to the meter. This one here is perfectly fine. This is the Fluke 322, and it does not test DC, but this is a bulletproof clamp meter I've used for years. And this one here is going to be used for testing the voltage. And we're going to test it on the chop saw, and we're going to review the readings, and you are just going to be amazed. So let's get to it right now. Okay, you ready? I got one camera on the meters and one camera on me. We're going to pull the trigger. Just pull the trigger. I'm not going to cut any wood right now, and we'll review the meter readings. Let's take a look. Okay, so I couldn't see the screen, but you guys could, and you could see that it is a maximum there of the amperage of 53 amps, and let's take a look at the voltage here. Now, I have to hit the min-max here to adjust it, but it was started at 120, that's the highest, went down to 107, and the average is 119. So you could see there is a huge drop in the voltage when it first starts up, and you can take a look at the amperage, and you could see, yeah, 53 amps starting. Now, of course, it drops down as you run the motor longer, but nothing is under load right yet. So let's do the same thing, except this time we're going to cut a piece of wood. Okay, this time, let's do the same test, except we're going to cut a piece of wood. As you can see right there, there's not much of a difference in change, is there? But you're still, the amperage is still pretty high. You're, that one there is showing 50. And let's look at the voltage here. Went down to 107. And not much of a difference was there. So once it gets spooled up, it seems to run just fine. So now let's move on to testing off the inverter. Okay, so here I am here, and I've taken the power cord out of the electricity outlet for the garage, and I'm going to plug it into the inverter. The only thing I've added is this meter right here that you'll see on the other camera is the voltage for the battery. But what I'd like to do first is just show you, before we get started, how many amps are actually in this battery. I like to test the amperage that's shown in the battery first, and then we'll do some cuts and you'll see how it affects the battery. Okay, so let's just hook up the battery here. Boy, we got a lot of cables going on here, don't we? I hope you can see that. Let me see if I can get that in the shot for you. I hope you can see that. But it's showing 12.78. So I did have this on the battery charger charging up, so it's fully charged. And cold cranking amps. I picked 800, but this is a battery from 2011. And it's an old battery, and it's not a motor battery. And it's not the battery you should be using to use for a power inverter, but this is for demonstration purposes only. So let's see how many cranking amps are in this. Well, we got cold cranking amps, 806. So that's not too bad, is it? So that's our baseline, 806. Okay, so for the first test, we're just going to pull the trigger and take a look at the meter readings and see if you can watch the blade here. So I'll hold the guard up here, and we're going to fire this up. Now, the first thing I did is I noticed that I'm only getting like 112 volts. You'll see, but it's only about 112 volts out of the inverter right now. So let's pull the trigger. Let's see what happens. Stalled right in its face. Stalled right in its face. So let's pull the trigger again, except this time, same thing, stalled on its face. Let's take a look at the meter readings and let's see what's going on. Okay, so if you take a look at the meter reading there, but you can see the battery's down to 12.2, and we got a maximum amperage of 29 amps. And the voltage was at 112. Let's see how much it dropped. 4.9 volts. An average of 107. Highest was 112, but this is the killer. 4.9 volts. Nothing can run on 4.9 volts. That's a 3,000 watt inverter. If you were to do Ohm's Law, buddy, you'd be shaking your head wondering how come this thing won't run. Well, I'm going to explain it. Okay, so I'll just review what happened there. Most people, when they go buy an inverter, they look at the inverter rating. This one here is 3,000 watts, 6,000 watts peak. It's got four receptacles on the front, and this inverter is different than the other ones I have because, as you can see, it's got four battery cables. So I've got a positive and a negative on the two receptacles on the left, and it's duplicated on the other side. So it's split right in half, 1,500 watts a side. But that's not in a utility. That is running off of a battery. And guess what happens when you run stuff off of a battery like that? You have peak current. So the peak current on this was 29 amps. So 15 amps is 1,800 watts. And you figure, okay, that's a 3,000 watt inverter. It should run it. No, 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 no. The majority of the time when you're going to look at an inverter, the amount of outlets on the outside is divided by the total amount of wattage provided by the unit. And that is no guarantee that it'll still run, because you have a lot of machines, or, you know, whether you're plugging this into a, you know, a light bulb is fine. 100 watts is 100 watts. But that there is not 1,800 watts, 15 amp. You know, motors and them kind of things that spike up high. You need an inverter. You can imagine how big an inverter you need. For to run this, I would probably get 3 times the size, just so you don't burn the thing out constantly. And so this is the thing that a lot of people get confused with when they're buying an inverter. Yeah, you just can't look at the amperage rating and figure you're going to do a little bit of Ohm's Law and say, you know what, this thing here runs at 1,800 watts. But no, 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 no. As you can see here, it don't quite work like that. So do you want to take a look at the battery now? And let's just do a another check on the battery and see how many amps are left in that battery. Now we'll test it again. Now it does say charge, and it has gone down a little bit. Well, I hope you like this little experiment on inverters, and a little bit touching on electricity a bit. And it just goes to show that you have to actually test, and it's nice to have some of the test equipment. You don't got to spend thousands of dollars to test this kind of stuff. Just a regular clamp meter and a digital multimeter, And test stuff before you actually put it into service, because a lot of bad things can happen when you're using a battery. And as far as I'm concerned, I believe there's more danger involved in a battery that size than your wall outlet. So yeah, you can really get hurt bad, you know, with battery, and if you don't know exactly what you're doing. So I hope you enjoyed this, a little bit of difference of, you know, of a vid. And if you haven't seen this channel before, you're welcome to subscribe and come back again. Let's have some more fun and let's do some more testing. Cheers.